This morning I've been studying about doors. Think about the doors that we live in our life. In the book of Job, 31st chapter, 32nd verse, Job, while pleading his case before God and talking about the life he's been living, and really he lived a great life, he said this. He said, "I have never closed my door to a stranger, but instead always opened it up to those who were out on the road before they had to sleep outside." And I thought about a call to hope and how cool Job 31, 32 would be as a theme verse for a call to hope all across America. We're getting ready to build buildings in Los Angeles to be temporary shelter and sometimes permanent shelter for the homeless. We're getting ready to make all kinds of rent controls, and maybe all we really need to do is encourage people to open their doors to the stranger so that not one night would anyone sleep on the road alone. Maybe what we really need to do is take these billions of dollars that we're about to spend on buildings and say, "Hey, you're having heartbreak in your household? You have a heartbreak with your family? Open the door. Build community. Be a community builder. Be one who calls to help, and we can help you financially as a nation, as a people." And then as people start to get their feet back on the ground, as they start to get jobs, we're not left with the remnants of great big housing projects, but instead we're left with community, with families who know each other, with people who love each other, with people who are being cared for. I believe in a call to hope. Fourth chapter of Genesis, God speaking to Cain, when Cain's complaining about not having his gift received appropriately by God, at least he didn't think it was received in the same way it should have been. And God speaks to him and says, "Be careful, just outside your door, evil is lurking. You've got to be cautious about it." I thought about in these days of celebration for the Jewish New Year, about the Passover and how the blood in Exodus was put over the door frame so the angel of death would fly over them, pass over them. And so that as the firstborn in every other household of every other type of animal would be killed, but the children of Israel would be alive and would be able to escape. Beautiful story in the Exodus if you haven't read it, thought about it in Deuteronomy, the promises of on your coming in and your going out. When you remember these words, how God will watch over you. And in so many places through the New Testament, but most prominently in the third chapter of Revelation, where Jesus says, "Behold, I have set before you an open door that no one can shut. Behold, I stand at the door and knock." Doors, they're pivotal to our life from the time we're little kids. When we were first starting our family and our daughter Julia was born, we had one of those things, maybe you had one in your household too, that has like a spring-loaded rope that hooks in the door frame up at the top. And we would stick Julia into the thing, and Julia loved the thing. She would bounce on that thing for hours if we would have let her. She'd go so high it would scare us to death, even as a little tiny kid, before she could walk. Oddly though, when John was born, we got it out, just assuming he would be the same. He didn't like the thing at all. Just didn't appeal to him in any way, shape, or form. I think each of us approach doors differently than the other. But all of us need to come to the door with an open heart, with open hands, with an open mind, with an open spirit for whatever God wants to do. Because every single time we shut a door, we have to be certain that what we're keeping out is that which we should be keeping out. So that every single time we see the stranger, the immigrant, the wayfarer, those who are hurting, those who are being abused, those who go without, those who are being left out, we know for those of us who believe in God, for those of us who were created to live a better life, that our job is to open the door. So like Job, our testimony at the end of our lives can be, there was never a time where I left a stranger outside to sleep on the street, but I always opened the door. Does that ever make us co-equal with God? No. Job gets absolutely crushed by God after that. You know, where were you when I created the heavens? I mean, go back and read it. He gets absolutely crushed by God for somehow acting like he was good in his own righteousness. And we're not. But we're so much better than if we lived with a clenched fist, with a hardened heart, with a closed door. Door is ready for you to open up today, all around you. And if you want to be the miracle in life, really, don't just be hanging out underneath the door. That's not the same thing. At some point, we have to move through that door. At some point, we have to open it. At some point, we believe that God has got something greater when we open the door to those who are going to come in, or when we walk through the door that God has set before us. That's how we become the miracle today. I want you to know that I'm praying for you this morning. My morning's been going since 4:30. I'm excited to get home and get showered and get to the office. I hope you have an absolutely fantastic day, that your miracle is just beginning as you open the door to the world all around you. Many blessings on the day out ahead. Know that I'm thinking about you.